Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Hamad Shaban. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace the personal representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, President of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, and Chairman of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, on the occasion of His Highness being honored by the Association of the National Olympic Committees. This honoring is considered one of the most prestigious awards presented to outstanding management figures in the field of Olympic sports, and the Bahrain Olympic Committee earned this award during the Association of the National Olympic Committee's General Assembly in Qatar. His Majesty congratulated His Highness Sheikh Nasser for earning this medal and hailed his role and efforts in strengthening the Olympic sports movement in Bahrain and hailed the various achievements made in this field. He also praised the Olympic champion Ruth Gibbett for earning the sports achievement from the Association of National Olympic Committees for her accomplishments at the Rio 2016 Olympics. He expressed pride for the honoring of His Highness, which reflects the appreciation His Highness receives from sports organizations on the local, Arab and international levels. His Majesty praised His Highness's successful leadership of the sports march in the kingdom and the accomplishments he made in this field, which reflected positively on Bahraini players in various regional and global championships. He highlighted that one of the most historical achievements was winning the gold and silver medals at the Rio 2016 Olympics.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى ملك مملكة البحرين حفظكم الله ورعاكم، أصحاب السمو والسعادة والسيدات والسادة، الحضور الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. سيدي صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى، بكل الفخر والاعتزاز تتشرف الأسرة الرياضية البحرينية ممثلة في سمو رئيس وأعضاء مجلس إدارة اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية ونخبة من رؤساء الاتحادات الرياضية في هذا اليوم الجميل المبارك الذي نتشرف فيه باللقاء والسلام على جلالتكم. حفظكم الله ورعاكم، فلقاء جلالتكم وسام فخر واعتزاز لكل مواطن على هذه الأرض الغالية. وجميل جدا أن تتزامن هذه الزيارة الغالية مع الإنجازات الرائعة والمشرفة التي حققها أبطال وبطلات البحرين في مختلف المحافل الرياضية. ومما يزيدنا فخرا أن مملكة البحرين متمثلة في اللجنة الأولمبية قد تجاوزت في إنجازاتها الميادين والملاعب وحازت على أوسمة رفيعة وجوائز تقديرية، من أبرزها حصول سيدي سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة الممثل الشخصي لصاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى للأعمال الخيرية وشؤون الشباب، رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة، رئيس اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية، على وسام اتحاد اللجان الأولمبية الوطنية الأنوك، وهي أكبر منظمة رياضية دولية، والتي منحت اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية جائزة التقدم المتميز كأفضل لجنة أولمبية على مستوى اللجان الأولمبية الوطنية في العالم. كما منحت العداء البحرينية روث جبت جائزة الإنجاز الاستثنائي على أدائها في أولمبياد ريو عام 2016. والجدير بالذكر سيدي أننا قد حصلنا على جميع مجالات الجوائز المقدمة من خلال اتحاد اللجان الأولمبية الوطنية الأنوك في اجتماعاتها بدولة قطر الشقيقة، وتعد هذه سابقة حصول بلد على جميع هذه الجوائز. سيدي جلالة الملك، ما حظيت به اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية من تكريم دولي رفيع المستوى عزز من مكانة البحرين الرياضية على مستوى العالم، وجاء تتويجها لجهود سموه في الارتقاء وتطوير الرياضة البحرينية في العديد من المجالات بعد أن تولى سموه رئاسة اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية في عام 2009، وأحدث نقلة نوعية في عمل اللجنة الأولمبية واستراتيجياتها، مما انعكس إيجاباً على الرياضة البحرينية، وبلغت العالمية والشواهد على ذلك كثيرة، يترجمها حصاد الرياضة والرياضيين البحرينيين في المواسم الماضية، حيث بلغت الميداليات الملونة 2286 ميدالية. وكلنا يستذكر أن سمو الشيخ ناصر عندما تولى زمام القيادة وتحمل المسؤولية بكل عزيمة وشجاعة وإصرار، رفع سموه شعار إننا لم نعد اليوم نبحث عن المشاركة ولكن عن الإنجاز والتميز. وقد استمد سمو الشيخ ناصر هذه الرؤية الثاقبة والاستراتيجية المبنية على أسس علمية من واقعنا وبما يتناسب مع إمكانياتنا، وحظى بكل الدعم والتوجيه والتشجيع من لدن جلالتكم حافظكم الله ورعاكم. ومشروع جلالتكم الإصلاحي الرائع العظيم الذي أحدث نقلة في البحرين الغالية في مختلف المجالات، وكان خير استثمار في الإنسان البحريني وقدراته. وأنتم سيدي حافظكم الله من وجه ودعم وبارك بتأسيس اللجنة الأولمبية البحرينية في عام 1979، وها هي البحرين تقطف ثمار غرسكم ورعايتكم الكريمة أدام الله عزكم، وها هو اليوم يتواصل عطاؤكم ورعايتكم الكريمة، ونحن بكل الفخر والاعتزاز نتشرف بلقاء جلالتكم حفظكم الله ورعاكم. وختاما نعاهدكم سيدي كما عهدتمونا، سنظل الجنود الأوفياء للبحرين وقيادتها الكريمة حفظها الله ورعاها، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a written letter to His Majesty Sultan Qaboos bin Said of Oman, inviting him to participate in the 37th GCC summit, which will be hosted in Bahrain next December. The letter was delivered by Bahrain's Charge d'Affaires in Oman, Khalid Ahmed Al Mansour, to the head of the GCC Directorate at the Omani Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Ambassador Mohammed bin Nasser bin Hamad Al Wahbi. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a written letter to the Emir of Qatar, His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, to participate in the 37th GCC summit, which will be hosted in Bahrain in December. The invitation was conveyed by Bahrain's Charge d'Affaires in Qatar, Nasser Faris Al Ghatami, to Qatari Foreign Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdurrahman Al Thani. His Rohaness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Qadabiyah Palace a number of royal family members. The Prime Minister affirmed the importance of strengthening ties among Bahraini citizens and noted the Bahrainis have national values that form a solid foundation for joint action and goals that are in favor of the nation and its people, which also meet the aspirations of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, who leads the nation's march with devotion and sincerity for the sake of his people. His Rohaness said that these meetings are an opportunity for exchanging views regarding the country's issues and fulfilling the needs of citizens. His Rohaness also noted that the aspirations for Bahrain's future are big thanks to the cooperation of all to accomplish more achievements that benefit the country. His Rohaness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Qadabiyah Palace the chairman of Ahli United Bank's Board of Directors, Hamad Mshari Al Humaidi, and the bank's board members. He affirmed the government's keenness on adopting economic tools that would enable financial and banking institutions to expand in Bahrain. The Prime Minister affirmed that the government continues to support the financial and banking sectors to be one of the leading supporters of the economic activity in the kingdom. He highlighted the role of Ahli United Bank and its prestigious status as a financial institution on the regional and international stage. He noted its success despite the prevailing regional and global economic conditions. His Royal Highness stressed the government's keenness on adopting strategies that reinforce its role as an incubator for financial institutions and that it continues to launch more programs in order to achieve this goal. He highlighted the achievements of Ahli Bank in training and employing Bahraini cadres and its effective participation in various financial activities. He reviewed the bank's plans and its current and future programs and noted its endeavor to expand its activities in the kingdom. He stated that it reflects the stability of the economic environment the government has created in Bahrain. Al-Humaydi expressed thanks to the kingdom's government, led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, for the support it provides to financial institutions in Bahrain and for the facilitation that attracts capital and investment. He commended the role of His Royal Highness in establishing a banking and finance sector that has a strong presence and a distinctive stature in the region. The Bahrain Royal Endurance Team, led by His Highness, the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, Captain of the Team, Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, has added a new glory to their series of accomplishments after winning the Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum Sports Creativity Award as the Best Arab Team. Receiving such a prestigious honor follows the team's victory in the World Youth Endurance Championship held in Chile in the year of 2015. On this occasion, His Highness Sheikh Nasser affirmed that receiving this very high status honor for the Bahrain Endurance Team would not have been possible without the unwavering support extended to the sporting movement in the kingdom by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, who is attentively and constantly following as well as backing Bahraini jockeys during their participation in all competitions in order to lift their spirits and motivate them to achieve best results. He also noted the support of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa for Bahraini sports and the interest of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness expressed pride in the royal team's winning of the award of the Vice President and Prime Minister of the UAE and Emir of Dubai, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, who is always keen on establishing the principles of innovation, creativity, and excellence in various institutions, especially the sports ones. Sheikh Nasser stated the importance of the award for its credibility in the sports field. His Highness affirmed that the accomplishments was a result of the hard work of all team members and the administrative, technical and media crew. Sheikh Nasser revealed that they are going to proceed on making both long and short-term plans and strategies that guarantee continued success on the global level. The first deputy chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, president of the Confederation of West Asian Athletics Association and president of the Bahrain Athletic Association, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, congratulated His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa on Arab Best Award. He also congratulated His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and His Highness the representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and President of the Bahrain Olympic Committee, Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, on the occasion of the Bahrain Athletics Association's winning the prize of the Best Arab Association Award by Arab Best Company during the awards distributions held recently in the Moroccan city of Marrakesh in recognition of the outstanding innovative athletics associations in the Arab world. His Highness Sheikh Khalid affirmed that this award is a result of the support of His Majesty the King to the Mother of All Games, as well as the support of His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the efforts of all members of the association and member clubs. His Highness expressed pride in the award, adding that it enhances the Kingdom of Bahrain's position on the global sports map. He stated that the award will motivate the association to exert more efforts to make more achievements in the future. During the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Hamad Al Khalifa's participation in the dinner banquet hosted by the Bahrain British Friendship Society in the UK, he affirmed that the course of relations between Bahrain and the UK is witnessing a remarkable progress in all areas of cooperation. Sheikh Khalid praised the historical relations between Bahrain and the UK and the progress in various fields after more than 200 years of collaboration, which resulted in the important growth of these ties on the political, economic, and military levels. The minister said that the UK Crown Prince Charles Al's visit to the Kingdom of Bahrain, his exploration of the Bahraini society and its diversity and plurality, and sets it apart with tolerance and coexistence between all of its components, was an additional opportunity to expand the ancient relations between the two countries and long-distinguished relations. Sheikh Khalid said that he is looking forward to the UK Prime Minister Theresa May's visit to Bahrain in December, which underlines the strategic value represented by the bilateral relations of the two countries and reflects a common determination to promote more prospects for cooperation on all levels. The minister praised the role of the Bahrain-British Friendship Society in strengthening the relations between Bahrain and the UK, wishing them continuous success in the various activities that aim to strengthen ties between the members of the society at Bahrain on the public and official levels. British Undersecretary for State for Middle East Affairs, Tobias Elwood, affirmed the strength and diversity of the distinct ties between the UK and Bahrain, praising the constant progress of these relations on all levels. The first deputy speaker of the Representatives' Council, Ali Al-Aradi, chaired today the weekly meeting, and the council approved a draft law regarding cost of living allowance. The council also discussed a report on amending the Criminal Procedure Code law and approved another report regarding applying the fingerprint system for people who are arriving in the kingdom by air, land or sea. The meeting then approved a proposal on coastal rehab and establishing public parks to practice walking, swimming, sports and fishing. Delegated by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Minister of Transportation and Telecommunications, Kamal bin Ahmed Mohammed, participated in the first global conference for sustainable transport held in the Republic of Turkmenistan, accepting the invitation of the President of Turkmenistan, Gurbanguly Berdimuhamedow, from the 26th until 27th of November of 2017. The minister pointed out that the conference has a large-scale presence from various members of the United Nations. The conference started with ministers' meetings with a plenary session with a statement about the importance of states' compliance with treaties on transport and their future aspirations regarding the development of projects that deal with transport. Subjects regarding the need to stop using old means of transportation and replacing them with modern ones were discussed because they are not compatible with the globally recognized health and environment requirements, as well as the lack of security and safety conditions, which can increase the problems faced by society and impede the process of economic development. The conference also touched on energy sources that finance these means and how to find a safe diversity that ensures preservation of those means among the highest specifications, as well as the need to focus on the infrastructure of modern transportation without damaging nature or influence, nor its residents. The Kingdom of Bahrain is marking on the 1st of December the Bahraini Women's Day, which is this year celebrating the achievements of Bahraini female workers in the judicial and legal fields. Public prosecutor Abdullah Al-Khashram confirmed that the wise leadership support to female workers in this sector has significantly contributed in their excellence.
Compared to other countries in the region, Bahrain has reached an advanced level in the field of human development by applying the United Nations principle in eliminating any kind of discrimination amongst workers, which based on gender, job creation and atmosphere. All of this with custom and traditions. All of this with Bahraini custom and traditions led women to enter workplace at all level and times, achieved development in many areas, as well as created a supportive workplace environment for women with no obstacles.